The four Polaris Dawn crew members are far, far from home. New Hampshire's Scott Poteet piloting them 1,400 kilometers away, our big blue planet down below.
Dragon, you've soared to over 1,400 kilometers, and you're farther from Earth than any other person since the last Apollo mission over 50 years ago.
It's one objective completed, but another to go. This is what the first ever commercial spacewalk is expected to look like around 2:30 Thursday morning. Two crew members will take turns popping out of the hatch, but staying close. It's focused on testing how these new spacesuits stand up in the vacuum of space.
It is hard to keep humans alive and safe in space, and so a new spacesuit measuring the impact of space on the human body are going to be really key.
The distance is also a danger. That area of space is filled with extreme radiation and debris.
That's the real danger zone. So right now, the ISS is protected by the Earth's atmosphere. So we don't think about the danger of radiation for those astronauts. But once you leave that realm and you go off into actual space, it becomes very hazardous.
We asked Melissa Edwards what would make this a successful mission. The first thing is getting the crew back safely.
Secondly, testing out the technologies and finding out what it's going to take for us to continue to live and work in space in those more, I would say, treacherous environments.
Now, Edwards says she hopes students today realize that they might be living and working in space one day down the line. That could be a reality, and they can shoot for being on the ground too, supporting astronauts doing those future missions.